Greetings, my dear ones. In order for a new world of high vibrations to reign on Earth, the old one must completely leave. And it is leaving right now. All cataclysms, catastrophes, epidemics, crises, are the agony of the outgoing three-dimensional world. They will not end for people who live in low vibrations, and choose the desires of their insatiable ego every day. Pain, as many people as possible were able to awaken, so that even more people could say, we are tired of darkness, of selfish desires, of illusory suffering and unnecessary pain and struggle. We choose light, God, divine being, soul and spirit, in comfortable living conditions. People, enjoying their egoism, will not wake up, since there is little time left. The old world is leaving with a roar and bang. The agony of the three-dimensional world is the last help for all mankind in awakening. How to react to leaving old world? My dear people, people who now live on very high vibrations, do not feel the agony of the outgoing three-dimensional world at all, as if it simply does not exist. There is no human suffering and pain for them, but not from the fact that they are heartless or live, closing my eyes to everything. They simply passed into the shining divine space in which they feel their soul, its call and its light. They feel the presence and wisdom of the immortal spirit, the one God for all. They feel life, its conduct, care and love. Although they are physically in the material plane, in fact, they have not been here for a long time. They came out of the three-dimensional reality of pain, suffering, and struggle. What if you are still reacting to the three-dimensional world, and see its agony? Don't get involved in these low energies. Of course, if you are full of spiritual strength, then you can watch the departure of this world, as if from the outside. To do this, you must accept it completely and completely as it is. The three-dimensional world is neither bad nor good. It is what it should be, to undergo a certain experience. And people who live on low vibrations are not bad, but simply get a low vibration experience. Everything is from God, but different vibrations, density, and manifestations. If the observation of the agony of the outgoing world touches, frightens and upsets you, then it means that you are being pulled into low vibrations, as if in a net. Get out of the old three-dimensional world, from the low vibration space and rush up into the light. Maintain a course for a positive life attitude, for trust in God and soul, for love for everything, for a new world of high vibrations. He seems to envelop the entire planet with love. He is ready to embrace everyone, letting him into his shining space. Let go of low energies and you will feel a reality in which peace and quiet, joy and love, simple happiness of being. Divine wisdom reigns in it and everything around is seen as the highest good. With love for everyone, Magda. Spiritual development. Practice and meditate. My dear ones, now such energies are pouring onto the earth, that seem to ask us all to confirm our conscious choice to return to the light, to the divine being. Someone may feel that they seem to be sucked into their networks, like a quagmire, the material plane, earthly life and human play, everyday affairs, in which you are definitely drowning, and there is no room left for energy practices and meditation, spiritual development and growth, cognition yourself. But this is not the case. This is a material experience in which many need to feel and make a firm and confident choice, to be limited by an unconscious person or an unlimited conscious divine being. The world is not divided into material and spiritual. The world is one, everything is divine in it. And it only depends on us, how we look at everything, from which side, through what. You can do absolutely everything in this world with the soul, live always with the heart, receive any experience consciously, feeling how matter is intertwined with subtle energy, as if playing in the divine dance of love. And any, even material experience, one can see spiritual development, and be in it, as we feel with our soul. In all meetings, one can feel the participation and presence of God, cognize him in him. Everywhere you can see how we are being carefully and lovingly guided, our consciousness expanded, and many hints and help are given. Everything depends only on us, on the fact that we choose every moment of our life, every day and hour. My dear ones, let no material experience drag you down. May you feel spiritual development in everything, your soul and spirit, God everywhere. May every day you more and more feel yourself, your divine being, and return to your light. My dear ones, we are all like receivers of the most diverse energy waves. For example, some in this world produce, receive, transmit a wide variety of low and dark energies, while others are light and shining. We seem to live on different radio waves, constantly switching channels, and choosing the wave we need. The vibration frequency, controlling our personal energy receiver as a device. We ourselves choose to rejoice and love us, shining on the whole world, or to pour discontent and dirt on everything around, the most diverse negative. Everyone chooses the right energy wave himself. What happens when we hear other people who have their own frequency, like a radio wave on a receiver? We also choose to stay at our vibration frequency or switch to them. Some people can lower our vibrations, because under their influence we connect to a negative and low frequency wave of energies. And only awareness can help to resist and stay on its own frequency, without getting involved in their energies. Others pull us upward, because with their joy, inspiration, positive attitude, pure and open love, with a shining wave of light, they switch to a high frequency. Then we will fly upwards blissfully. Can we switch others to our wave of energies? Of course, we can offer to switch to our frequency, while not insisting, and always leaving the right to choose. We invite people to switch to a higher vibration frequency, when we begin to change the negative topic of conversation and offer another, when we show something brighter and more beautiful, when we humorously bypass sensitive and painful topics for many, when we communicate with soul and warmth. My dear ones, feel your energy frequency that you choose, and broadcast into this world every day. Feel the vibrations of others. Choose light and let your mindfulness help you to shine. My dear ones, day after day each of us in any life situation has a choice, to act as the soul wants, God is within us, or standard and stereotyped, according to the model, with the mind and ego. What drives us? What drives us? How to understand this? How to distinguish? How to recognize? When we follow a limited mind, like a mini computer in our head, we make a choice, based on the experience of our own past and other people, a wide variety of life patterns and patterns. The mind always thinks, weighs, explains logically. He, as a program, seeks the best choice, based on the data that we gave him. He weighs all the pros and cons, choosing what is closer, more profitable and more convenient for the human ego. And this choice is often accompanied by worries, fears, doubts. From this we feel that our soul is not calm, not easy. When we follow the soul, then, having cast aside or at least pushed into the background, temporarily pacified, all the desires of our human ego, we begin to feel that our true nature really wants. Then our heart and God within us are revealed. Thanks to this, we simply intuitively know, feel how and how to act in a given life situation. And this choice gives us incredible inner goodness, boundless peace, joy, and happiness. Inside we feel the warmth of the soul, its unconditional love. We feel that she is leading, and we are walking right. My dear ones, and every step, every choice can be made consciously, feeling everything that is happening inside. You can follow the soul, its light. This is the inner divine revelation, the revelation to God of what is in each of us. My dear ones, on the subtle plane of the planet, a world has long been seen where there is no struggle, where there is no battle between light and darkness, where there are no good and bad. This is a huge shining space that precisely envelops the entire planet in a snow white airy blanket. This is a reality that seems to float above the three-dimensional human consciousness. And the entrance to this shining reality has long been open to all people. This is life in divine unity and love. I see that there are people who have already reached this level of vibrations, strive and leave the dualistic game. People open up to the boundless acceptance of everything, the vision of God and everything, the unity and integrity of the divine space. And for such people there is no longer the world of the battle of light and darkness, but there is only the one divine space. For them, there are no more good and bad ones, since everyone is simply at their own level of vibrations, the opening of consciousness, and receives their own experience. For them there is no longer any struggle in life, since a complete acceptance of everything, a feeling of the conduct of life, trust in God and the soul opened up inside. My dear ones, everyone can walk this path, day after day returning to their own light. It's time to move into the shining divine space that is open for all mankind, the world of the new earth.